Beg your pardon. Actually, now I am starting from gate 10 of thyristor. Gate 10 of thyristor is having three terminals. One is anode, one is cathode, one is gate. And it is under one category of SCR. For gate 10 of thyristor, it is normally acting as an SCR when it is for turn-on characteristics. But if we will go for turn-off characteristics, then there will be something different procedures or something different approach we have to take. Now, just see over here, these are the basic symbols of gate turn-off thyristor. Anode is here, cathode is here, you can see gate over here. That means gate turn-off thyristor, this will be showing the exact output in the forward direction. Of course, gate turn-off thyristor, it can be working as you can see over here, it is bidirectional in nature. So, if we will use the term gate turn-off thyristor, we can tell that the SCR generally that cannot be turned off by using the gate, but for GTO we can do this particular thing, and this bidirectional arrow in this symbol it is indicating that the gate current flow in both the directions, and to turn off this GTO or gate turn off thyristor, a gate current that is about 1/5 of the anode current, this is very important, the IT should be 0.2 of IA. The gate current should be 1/5 of the anode current, and that is required. The turn on and the turn off, this characteristics or this characteristic time or the total time for turn on as well as turn off for GTO, that is less than that of SCR. So these are some properties. Number one, it is bidirectional. For gate current, number two, the gate current should be 1/5 of the anode current, and number three, the total time for turn on plus turn off of GTO that is less than that of turn on plus turn off of SCR. So these are the three characteristics. Now let us see how this gate turn off thyristor is working actually. Now from symbol we are coming to the equivalent circuit. Say this is voltage supply. Thank you.
Just a second, please.
So now let us explain what do you understand by the term of characteristics. Now let us see this equivalent diagram of GTO when it is going for term of characteristics. First there is a voltage supply. Along with that there are two transistors TR1 and TR2. There is one GTO. There are one resistor and capacitor that is in conjugation with this GTO, which is providing the time constant. There is another thyristor, along with there is a coil. Now, whenever we are going for the normal turn on characteristics, it is very much similar to that of SCR. How it will work actually? If I am writing IA over here, it will be going like this. Here we are getting the holding current. Here we are having the latching current. This is the on state. this is the off state. This is the position when the gate is triggered. This is the forward breakover voltage. Now, let us come in from this to this figure. So you can see over here, this is the conventional ladder. That means when we are approaching this forward breakover voltage, until then the gate is not triggered. After that, the value of alpha 1 and alpha 2, which will indicate the amount of minority loosely wound carriers in the depletion region, will increase, and so the gate is triggered, and after that, in the on state, we will get latching current. Remember, always with any type of SCR, latching current is much more than that of holding current. Latching current is that minimum amount of current in the on state for an SCR after the forward breakover voltage, and holding current is the minimum current which will make the SCR in the off state just to achieve the forward breakover voltage. Now coming to this particular graphical representation, let us see over here. I have just divided into portion A and portion B. In the portion A, we can see over here, this is the portion when there will be the forward current. Or you can see at this one I have marked by IA. After that, this is the portion, or you can say this is the standard portion where we are getting a standard or steady value of current. At the same time, we are getting a steady value of voltage. So IA is what? IA, or this IA, is nothing but the anode current. And VA, this is nothing but the anode voltage. So both of them are steady, starting from t equal to 0. After that, this particular time period, until when there will be steady value of current as well as voltage, this is known as storage time. After that, we can see over here, TF is written, which is known as foil time. There is a sharp declination, there is a declination in the anode current, and there is a sharp increase in anode voltage. This is nothing but the foil time. After foil time, we are coming to this portion, which is nothing but tail current, and this time has been given as T in suffix T, that is nothing but tail current. We can see over here, after the ending of foil time, there is an abrupt change in the particular anode current, which is nothing but known as tail current. We can see over here, at the beginning of tail current, or the beginning of tail time, there is one overshoot we are getting in the voltage, which is nothing but the anode voltage, which is known as spike voltage. Now, what is the application of gate during this time? We can see over here, it is a negative ramp. That means a negative gate voltage we will apply with respect to cathode, and that is for the storage time, and then we are getting over here this particular value of steady anode current and this particular value of steady anode voltage. After that, we can see over here, this is negative. Here di by dt for Ig, that value is negative in this region. This is the particular region. And after that, we can see over here, now it is recovering. Now it is in the maximum position, maximum negative position. From where it is recovering, it is going towards zero, and we are getting in this position, of course, still decrease in there will be a decrease in anode current, there will be a sharp increase in anode voltage, there will be spike voltage. At the end of foil time, there will be an abrupt change in the anode current, which is nothing but tail current. And you can see over here, after the spike voltage, the anode voltage is increasing again. And why this is happening? This is happening because of gate characteristics, because of gate inductance, because of loosely wound carriers. And after a certain overshoot, there will be a position when the supply voltage is equal with the anode voltage, that is a steady state condition. Now, how this circuit can be stabilized? This circuit can be stabilized by the time constant of this series resistance and series capacitance by the multiplication factor of both of them. So, this is for GTO. So, from this particular diagram, we can make out one thing. Number one, GTO, for any GTO, it is complex compared to that of SCR. And if it is complex compared to that of SCR, then the value of holding current and latching current of a particular GTO, it should be much more than that of SCR. That means there should be much heating effect related to GTO compared to SCR. One more thing, the efficiency or the speed of operation, as because this is a complex circuit, there are more complex circuitry, of course the operation of GTO, speed of operation of GTO is much more compared to that of SCR. So now we can come to the next portion, which is nothing but diode. Now, this is the diagram of diet, the block symbol, block diagram, and the working. How we can split this word? Diet. If we will split this word, di means back to back, two SCRs, and AC means ability to conduct in both the direction. That means the diet should have graphical representation like this. If this is I of D, if this is V, this is V of FB1, this is V of FB2, this is IH, this is latching current 1, and this is latching current 2. Just see over here, for diet there are actually four junctions: J1, J2, J3 and J4. Four junctions, five layers: N1, P1, N2, P2, N3. So there are five layers. This diet, it is actually having two terminals, MT1 and MT2. What is our objective? Our objective is to make either MT1 positive with respect to MT2 or to make MT2 positive with respect to MT1. So first, let us make MT2 is positive with respect to MT1. And at that time, we are having this graphical representation. If it is positive with respect to MT1, that means this transistor 1, this is the two transistor analogy, we are making the cut over here. This transistor 1 is forward biased, that means J2 and J4 forward biased, J3 in reverse biased. And if we will increase the voltage, we are knowing the forward breakover voltage, of course J3 will break down. The reverse bias, this will break down and it will make or it will create more loosely bound carriers. So similar characteristics we will get that of SCR. Now if MT1 is positive with respect to MT2, then what will happen? Then this one, this graph, that means then this is in forward bias, J1 in forward bias, J3 in forward bias, but J2 in reverse bias. That means again if we will just increase the voltage, the junction J2 will break down. That means there will be a conduction of current from MT1 to MT2. So hence we are getting this kind of curve. Now what is the advantage? It is used for the triggering of trial. If we will use one more symbol over here, then the D will gone, triac will come. Triac means, in this case what will happen? Again, this is four junction, Of course, there are four junctions, and of course, there are five layers like N1, P1, N2, P2, and N3. But number of terminals now it will be three. One is NT1, another one is NT2, and gate is being attached with that. So in this case, what will happen? The similar type of graphical representation we will get, but remember, first we have to check the polarity, whether the gate is given positive voltage or negative voltage. Depending on that, there will be gate triggering for positive conduction and for negative conduction. If at all, it will be covering only one particular layer, then this is known as plus one conduction or minus one conduction. If it will considering three layers for positive, then it, for positive gate current, it will be plus three conduction or minus three conduction as per the polarity of gate current. So for what purpose triac is used actually? Triac is used for all those circuits where we are giving AC voltage as input. Now, we are coming to the last portion, which is nothing but light activated SCR. LA-SCR. Light activated SCR means LA-SCR. How? Anode, cathode, gate. Light is coming over here. How the operation is being done? This is one circuit, this is known as controlling circuit. This is the power circuit. So for an LA-SCR, we can see over here when we are applying certain pulse voltage over here, that time the LED will be in the conduction, just to make LED in the conduction state. This resistance is controlling the current that will pass through LED. The light will be falling on the gate terminal of the SCR. That means now the SCR, there will be gate triggering, the SCR will be on state. Whatever be the current throughout this power circuit, that will be controlled by this resistor. And the voltage is given over here just to control the overall operation of this circuit. So this much was my topic. Next day, we will cover R-triggering, RC-triggering, UJT, series and parallel operation of SCR along with the UJT as a relaxation oscillator. Thank you very much.